It is amazing what things you find in your archive cupboard in my back room. Last year, I found my old Nikon stills camera, made a video about it. This year, I found this folder, which pertains to this iPod. And it's leading me to tell you a story about the first video I ever made 20 years ago, all centered around this iPod. So our story starts at Epsom Station, a place in a town that I'm very familiar with, at least I thought I was, but that's changed and been rebuilt since last time I was here. Fortunately, I can see that the popular chain of chicken restaurant where our story starts many years ago is still there. So the date is Sunday the 9th of November 2003. Me and my friend Stephen, we both lived in Epsom at the time, had been out, four of us with our girlfriends, for a day trip up in London to come back out of the station, cross the road to here to get some tasty chicken for dinner. We did that thing where you sort of empty your pockets onto the table, typically your mobile phone, but new to the arsenal of things to empty out onto the table was Stephen's new iPod. They'd been around from Apple since 2001 for Mac only, but they'd recently brought out a Windows only version, and I really wanted one. Trouble was they were quite expensive at £250. Now, it was November, so December, Christmas is coming up. I think it might have been me that made the joke that went, maybe I could get like, you know, family and friends to like, you know, chip in 10, 20 pounds, although that seemed like a thing that a 14-year-old would do and not a 29-year-old, so I kind of dismissed it. And then Stephen went, what would be really funny, because of the song 50 Cent in the Club, he went, imagine if you got 500 people to all give you 50p, and then you could call it 50 pence in the pod. And we sat there and we laughed about it and thought, what a ridiculously stupid idea that would be. But at that moment, Stephen's girlfriend pushed a 50p across the table towards me, slid it over and went, there you go, Jeff, there's your first 50p, just 499 people to go. By the way, I think it was this exact table here, in this window seat here, that we were sitting. That's where it started. Now, I already have my website at jefftech.co.uk, so it's very easy for me to add a section slash 50 pence, and onto there, I would add everybody's name that gave me 50p, and if they agree to it, I would get a photo taken with them as well. And in that photo, I'll then embed and add a number, their own unique contributor number. Came up with a fun idea of getting everyone to nominate a song in their name and their contributor number, which I would then put onto my iTunes and onto the iPod. So I would carry around my contributor's choice of music. The irony there is that if I didn't own the song, I had to source it or download it, often costing me 59p from the iTunes store. So just off Oxford Circus, I'm sitting in Cavendish Square, just around the corner from BBC Broadcasting House, where I used to work. And the first day back into work after deciding to do this, I waited until lunchtime. I used to come and hang out here a lot in Cavendish Square and eat my sandwich at lunchtime, but I asked all my colleagues if they'd like to contribute to this 50p thing, and it very quickly took off from there. In fact, it was weird just how quite quickly it took off, because this was in the days before Twitter and before Facebook, and I think people were just sharing my website around via email. I also used my work address as the address for people to send in mail to me so that when people wanted to send physical 50p's in the post, which they did, they'd like sellotape them down to a piece of card and use my work address. So my work address became this point where I would get mail and I would then bring it here to Cavendish Square at lunchtime and open up and see what people had written to me along with the 50p's. And like I say, in the days before social media, it somehow just became really popular. I'm still not really sure how. I mean, I did have some London Underground content on my website at that time. Maybe that drew people to it. In the end though, a key thing that happened is that there was an iPod website called iPodlounge.com. I have no idea if it's still running or not anymore. And somebody put a link on there and that got quite a lot of feedback. Not all of it good. It was the first time I'd ever experienced sort of negative, nasty comments on the internet. Wow, I've had many years of that. But it did drive traffic to my site, and people that thought the project funny, that wanted to invest, then came to my website and donated 50p's. So I kept going and I asked people to just, you know, share my website and send it around, and people in turn would then send back things to me so I would get what were memes of the day about iPods and iTunes and stuff that were going around. One in particular was that I got sent a lot of times where there was this guy in New York that made a viral video, again in the days before social media, about how iPod's battery replacement program cost almost as much as a new iPod himself. You may have heard of this guy. Some YouTube person called Casey Neistat made a video about that. That was the first time I'd heard of him and the first time that I was aware of the concept of a viral video. So that Starbucks on Regent Street I used to go to all the time. I'm pretty sure that all the people that used to work there gave me 50p. Some weird things happened around this time. One, I appeared in the Italian version of Macworld magazine. Thanks, Italian Macworld. I think off the back of that, a university professor in Belgium somewhere used me as a case study as to sort of how these social experiments take off. It was like an experiment. People like Danny Wallace and Dave Gorman were doing similar things at the time. And one day in at work, Dave Gorman was plugging, I think, the Google Whack book and tour, and I caught Dave Gorman outside Broadcasting House saying, "Dave, would you give me 50p? And anticipating that he would say no, I actually had a sign ready. So I've got a picture of him and me saying, "No, Jeff, I will not give you 50p. My friend Miles, that worked on Radio 2 Steve Wright Show website of the day, made me website of the day, and that sent me some more clicks and hits. Yeah. Oh, we've got to go to Camden. Camden Lot Market, to be more precise, where a very strange thing happened. Now, Stephen, who'd been there right at the beginning, has been a long friend of mine, and he's a talented musician. He makes songs. He made a particular song for me back in 2017. He was making music back then, 20 years ago. And because he'd had the idea of calling it 50 pence in the pod, based upon the 50 cent in the club song, he had this cheeky idea of getting the instrumental track of that and getting me to rap over the 50 cent track with some lyrics pertaining to collecting money for an iPod. And we did it. The track doesn't exist anymore, thankfully, but it was a fun thing to do. I must have given copies of it to some people because about 3 months later, I got an email from someone that was like, Jeff, I was walking around Camden Market yesterday on Saturday and I heard the 50 Cent song start up, except it wasn't the 50 Cent version. You then started rapping and for some reason, somewhere in a market stall in Camden Market had downloaded and started playing my version. That's just weird, but apparently it happened. Okay, where are we? Oh, I know. Back to Kingston on the train. And I did, of course, get there in the end. It took 7 months from November 2003 until June 2004 to get to 500 people. 500 brilliant people who saw the fun in it. By the way, some of those 500 people tried to give me more than 50p, and if that was the case, I would reject their contribution or give them change. Like, someone gave me £5 once, so I just PayPal'd them back £4.50. Also, only about 300 of those 500 people actually chose a song to go on my iPod, but what's brilliant about that is that to this day, those tunes are still in my iTunes in the cloud with their name and number attached to it. So often if I'm just playing music on my iPhone, on the iPod app, a reminder of that contributor still comes up. It's on my iPhone, on my iTunes to this day, which is just a lovely thing. But I came to here on the 20th of June 2004 to buy the iPod, and I know that because I've kept the receipt with the date to this day here from Richer Sounds in Kingston. And my friend Andy that I worked with at the BBC came down with his then brand new DV digital video recorder because he was like, we should capture the moment on video. So he did that, and in capturing that little moment on video, it made me think maybe I should make a fuller video about the whole thing. I held something that I called an iParty. What's an iParty? Well, basically, I hired a venue in central London. I invited all 500 people that had contributed money to come along and celebrate all things iPods. When people did, I gave them a little badge. So instead of their name, they had a badge number. We had like draw your own, design your own iPod competition. Someone did me a London Underground theme one. Somebody made iPod cakes, which was amazing. Also, the centerpiece was this sort of 5 foot tall, it was a wooden frame iPod, which I'd covered in newspaper paper mache, and I had this giant iPod, which I remember clearly carrying home on the central line, but sadly I didn't take a picture of it. If I'd have had some giant white headphones as well, that would have been something to rival like a Dom Jolly hello moment. Anyway, we had this party, and at the party we had a playlist of music, again made up of all the music that people had suggested on my iPod, and also I played a video which I alluded to a minute ago, which I had made. And the reason why I'm here at John Lewis in Kingston is because these posters here, which are now advertising coffee, were at the time advertising iPods, and that was the opening shot to my video. And the relevance of that is that I realized the other day was the first video that I'd ever made in my entire life. This is back in the days when Adobe Premiere was like version 6 and before YouTube, so I've never published it to YouTube, and you're gonna see it in a minute, but not until I've taken you to another couple of locations. So by the time I'm making this, it's late 2004, and I was working at the BBC at White City, so I wanted two locations, both on the tube. So I came to Shepherd's Bush and another one, which we'll go to in a minute, which had iPod posters up, and here at Shepherd's Bush they had some. So from a tube point of view, what's great is that I've got all this footage of how the station looked before it was refurbished. Because the entrance exit used to be here, where this glass wall now is, and this wall wasn't here, and that was all just like a solid wall all the way down, which I walked past in the video. Okay, next location. And after Shepherd's Bush, we then came to here on the Hammersmith and City and Circle Now station, Latimer Road. Nowadays it's painted in this kind of cream and brown colour. Back then it was a different colour completely, old C-stock trains, and I got modern S-stock trains. But just about here, there used to be advertising posters up on the wall. And because I couldn't find a tube station, I just really wanted a shot of me at a tube station with an iPod poster, an advertising poster. I bought my own one, a gigantic blue poster off of eBay, and we had the temerity to come here. I mean, you'd never do this nowadays because there's like CCTV there. They'd come and like tell you off in a second. And we stuck up and we hung on the wall my own iPod poster with, I don't know, blue tack, and then waited for a train to come in, and Mark then filmed me getting onto the train and then jumping off the train and walking past, sort of looking at this iPod poster right here. I can't believe I did that, but it made it into the final film, so it looks awesome. Oh, do you want to see the final film? Okay, so the video, the first video I ever made. Well, it's either a link in the corner and or a link in the description, because I'm not going to embed it here, it's a separate video. The reason why I've uploaded it as a separate video is because it uses a Pet Shop Boys music track, which I was a big fan of at the time. So link below in the description if you want to go and watch that video. And yeah, that really is the first video I ever made and edited in my life. And it's not bad, considering that I did that 20 years ago. Yeah, it's kind of fun to watch back, and is in itself like a mini 3-minute version edited story highlights of the whole 50 pence iPod saga. Okay, right, we're almost at our final stop. Back in Epsom, station just there, Might go and get some chicken around the corner in a minute. But that is the story of how back in 2003, 20 years ago, my goodness, I managed to somehow convince 500 people to give me 50 pence each so that I could get an iPod. It was just an incredibly fun thing to do. Aside from the detractors, it's just nice to meet new people, engage, and have interesting stories like this to tell. So if you're one of the original 500, again, thank you. Why not go and play the song which you nominated to have on my iPod to this day? I'm about to put my headphones on my iTunes iPhone and listen to my playlist from 20 years ago of all the songs that you chose. That's it. That's my 50 pence in the iPod story. Press subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Bye.